Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2003 epic period action drama film called The Last Samurai. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The story begins where a foggy mountaintop flashes on the screen, and a man on the background who has a story to tell. He is telling a story or a myth on how Japan is made. It is said that there is a god that gets a sword from the ocean, and four droplets from the sword became the island of Japan. But the man disagrees, saying that Japan is made from a handful of brave men willing to sacrifice their lives for their homeland. A bald man sitting on a field, holding a look-alike rosary, and seems like is praying. His vision is a foggy forest where a Japanese is combating a tiger in the wild, and then he opens his eyes with a furious look. After a short glimpse, the story then changes in an American setting where there is a man sitting down, and some announcer on the background introducing what the event is, and saying about the true American national hero while the man is sipping on his liquor. The announcer is calling his name as Captain Nathan Algren, and everyone in the audience is expecting him, but he never stood up on his chair, and the announcer says to give him a moment, and when the announcer went to Nathan, and he is very upset saying that Nathan is fired, and that could be his last performance for he is so sick of him on behaving like that. Nathan stood up, and went to the stage. He showed everyone his gun, saying that it is the gun that made him win conquering the West. He tells the story of his fallen comrades, and the crowd sympathizes with him, and then he explains how his gun works, and the crowd is in shock as he creates a commotion loading the gun, and firing it into somewhere without the intention of harming anyone in the crowd. He just throws his gun to the crowd then left. He exited on a door, and there is an old man clapping, and waiting for him. Nathan recognizes the old man, and says in awe that the old man is alive. As the two of them are walking, the old man proposed a job for them, saying it is a good opportunity. Nathan asks what the job is, but the old man only says that the job is tailored for him. The two of them entered a restaurant, and then there are a couple of soldiers sitting there, and one greeted him, and introduces to man named Okamura, who says to be from Japan with his associates that he gives up because of the complicated name that he can't figure out how to pronounce. They are both invited to sit with them, and had some discussion about how he will be trained some Japanese samurai, which is what a warrior called in America. Okamura offered him $400 monthly, but he says that it should be $500, and another $500 if their work is done. Then Nathan stood up, but the colonel followed him to ask what is wrong. Nathan replies that he will kill whoever it is that needs to be killed for 500 bucks, but he is willingly will kill the colonel just for free. Nathan traveled and landed on Yokohama Harbor. He was greeted by a man named Graham. Graham explains a little bit of how the city is quiet, and now is as busy as the people could. They rode a vehicle pulled by two people. Graham explains that the Emperor of Japan has hired different professionals from the East, like architects, engineers, and now they hired warriors, which is them. Graham says that he is a translator. They are on their way to the Emperor to greet him, and the Emperor thanks them for taking the job. Nathan with his comrade starts to train the Japanese soldiers. Nathan takes interest to a samurai named Katsumoto. The samurai is popular, and is treated to be a hero for he is not using any firearms in a battle. After the training, the three of them went to where they are staying. With the curiosity Nathan bears, he is looking at some Japanese books about the samurai. He asks if Graham has a translated one, and he says that he is still in the process of making one. Nathan's comrade says that Nathan is also a linguist one, and Graham asks for an example on how he would tell of peeling a skin. Nathan at first doubted if he would do it or not, but then he starts describing it, threatening Graham that he would be peeled that way if he can't translate the book in time. But while Nathan is describing about the peeling, flashback of his memories flashes on how they have raided the Indians. Some are women, and most of them are children who are innocents. They fired without hesitation on whom they will aim, as those innocents run for their lives without any time to defend themselves. He argued with the colonel that those Indians have nothing to do with the rebellion, but the colonel insisted that they must kill them as they are instructed to. Nathan doesn't have a choice but to follow, and he came back to his reality with a teary eyes. They are back on the training, and Nathan mentions that they are lucky that the soldiers are aiming for just one direction, even though some bullets just hit the target, the most of them missed it. He went to a soldier and instructed him himself from the formation to sight, and when the Japanese soldier fires, he hits the bullseye. Okamura is coming to their way and utters his name. Okamura says that Katsumoto is on his move of his rebellion, and they cannot move freely on a certain province. Nathan says that the soldiers are not ready, but the colonel suggested that the rebels don't have any single rifle, and only have their bows and arrows. Nathan then gets his gun, and says that the soldier must shoot, and if not, he will be the one shooting back. The soldier is so furious that he didn't want to do it, but Nathan pressures him by shooting his hat. The soldier then aims, but he didn't hit Nathan. Nathan walks out saying that they are still not ready. But the colonel insisted that they are going to battle, and find Katsumoto at 6 in the morning. The next day, they are traveling down to province, and there are houses burned, and the place is a wreck, and people are traveling from place to place. Graham asks Nathan how they are going to find the samurai, but Nathan answers that they won't, but the samurai will be the one who will find them. They reach the Yoshino province with the soldiers he trained, and commands them as they are in the forest, and he is preparing them into battle. As Nathan shouts to load their rifles, many of them have shaky hands, and some don't know what to do for they are all scared of what will happen. They are all in a very heavy tension when they hear the opponent's screams, but they are in out of sight. When the enemies are at sight, Nathan says that they will aim on his order, but some fires instantly for they are all scared, and there's no time for the reload. Most soldiers run, and the samurais with their horses as they attack. A bloody war is happening, and it seems that the rifle is no match for the samurai swords. As the war is happening, the Japanese general runs as Nathan, and his comrade Zeb fights with their swords. Zeb is attacked by a spear of one of the samurai, and then the samurai gets down on his horse to strike Zeb with his sword. Nathan is distracted, and he fell from his horse, but still fights even though he was showered with wounds from different spears. The leader of the samurai saw him still standing and fighting against many of his warriors, and watch it with his own eyes as he walks towards him. One of a higher position from the samurai says that he will be the one who will kill Nathan, but Nathan lying on the ground strikes and kills him first. The other warriors are going to strike him at once, but Katsumoto commands them to stop, and take him away alive. The other warriors ask Katsumoto why he keeps Nathan alive, and he answers that they are going to face many killings, and they should be learning from a new enemy. The woman named Kata treats his wounds and takes care of him. Katsumoto gets a book from Nathan's bag. Nathan wakes up and he is haunted by his memories on how they slaughtered those Indians. Few days passed, and he wake up with a heel body, and roams around the village. He observes how those rebels are living, and how they are training their warriors. Someone escorts him to Katsumoto, who is in a temple, and they are having a conversation. Nathan asks who is the one in the red suit who he killed, and also asks who is the one taking care of his wounds. Katsumoto replies the one in the red suit is his brother-in-law, and the woman who is taking care of him his sister. He utters to himself that he killed Kata's husband, and yet she still takes care of him, and even fed him. Nathan went back to the temple, and asks what Tanaka wants from him, and says that he wants to know his enemy for they are both students of war. Tanaka asks Nathan if he is the commander when they conquered the Indians, and he says that he is only a captain, which is a middle rank. Tanaka ended the conversation as he is jotting down something on a paper. As time passes by, Nathan learns so many things, the discipline, the courtesy, and how everyone trains on what they are pursuing, and one thing he learns that the word samurai means to serve. He is also learning some Japanese words and the katana. The villagers are having fun with a theater act like when assassins came, and a bloody encounter happens. Nathan is about to lose to one of the assassins, but the child bravely gets his father's sword to distract the assassin. Nathan retrieves a knife, kills his opponent, and when one assassin is about to strike the child, he then stabs the assassin first. Nathan and Katsumoto fight side by side, to defeat the assassins. It is now spring, Nathan and Katsumoto are having a conversation about Katsumoto's poem, and Katsumoto says that if the emperor wants him dead, he just needs to ask, and Nathan figures out that the emperor is not against Katsumoto, but with Okamura. Katsumoto says that he should be leaving the village since the emperor asked. The samurais escorted Nathan. Nathan now is in the camp, and the emperor is having a conversation with Katsumoto. The emperor is asking him what he is going to do to save his people, and Katsumoto replied that he should be the one who will seek for the solution, for he is blessed with wisdom. On the other side, Nathan is asked questions about how the samurais are living, specifically armies, and all about war, but he just replies that he doesn't know, for he is a captive. Okamura asks for some privacy with Nathan, and talks about him leading Okamura's army. He says that they are going to have a new contract about it. Nathan walks away, and Okamura asks one of his men that he should kill Nathan instantly when he has any contact with Katsumoto. This time the rebellion has come to halt, and samurais are everywhere in Tokyo. Katsumoto is about to enter the Japanese council, but Okamura says that he should not be bringing his katana inside the room, but he refuses to do it unless the emperor had to say it. The emperor does not say any single word, and Okamura says that he should be escorted out. Katsumoto is now in a different room, and a man is about to stab him with a knife, but the man gives him the knife, and says that he should be the one doing it to himself. On the other side, Nathan is about to leave Japan for he is paid, but when he is outside, men ambushed him, but he then conquers the battle, and he just realized what he just did, and it seems like he is a samurai himself. Nathan went to the place where Katsumoto is confined. He says that they should leave the place, and he is saving him. When they are about to escape, guards are hunting them with guns. Most of them pass the bridge, but Katsumoto's son is left behind, and he is shot, and he fell down. Nathan tried to save him, but he is now in a worse condition. Katsumoto's eyes are filled with sadness and anger. His son says that they should leave him for he has done serving his purpose. It took minutes for Katsumoto to decide to leave his son. As the rest are escaping, Nathan watches the son to fight with his arrow and bow against those with rifles. They are back to the village, and expecting that there would be a bloody war. The whole village prepare themselves. Nathan tells Katsumoto the war about the Persians for having a small number of soldiers, and yet still fight with thousands of enemies, and that are they going to do? Nathan suggests that they need to make their enemies close to them enough to have fight with their swords. The day has come and Taka says that it would be an honor if he could wear the red armor his husband left. Taka dresses him, and they both felt the compassion and kisses each other. They are now ready to fight, and is now taking the battlefield. Thousands of soldiers are there. They greeted each other, and the colonel can't believe that he is seeing Nathan with the samurais. Nathan only says that he will be glad if they could see each other on the field. Each troop are on their positions. The Japanese regime has their cannons and firearms. The Japanese regime starts the attack with their cannon, and no one falters with the samurais. They remain standing on their ground, bravely. Another cannon attack was launched, and it causes damage to the samurais that make them retreat, which is also a part of the plan so that the Japanese regime should be close. The plan success, and now they are hiding in their wood barriers, and the soldiers shoots and aim their gun. Nathan says that they should wait for them up until they are going to load their rifles, and when that happens, they attack. All the brave samurais fight against those men with rifles. They are still fighting even though they are hurt with those bullets. The field is almost covered with bloods. A never-ending troop of the Japanese regime are coming to them, and only a few of them are left. They have decided to attack even though they are really few. They bravely face the opponent, and when they are close, Katsumoto is badly hurt. One of the general commands to halt the firing. Nathan says if Katsumoto is ready, and he helped him stab himself so that it is the way wanted to die, by the sword, and the last thing he may see is the spring of the sakura. The troops are kneeling down with their respect to Katsumoto's death. Nathan bravely went to see the emperor while having a ceremony treaty with the Americans, but then it is stopped while he is offering the sword of Katsumoto. Okamura says that Nathan is an enemy, and Nathan just says that he will gladly accept his death if that is the way the emperor thinks. The emperor gets the sword, and cancel the treaty ceremony that is going on, and he is really upset and command Okamura to stop his madness. The story ends with a narration of what happened to Nathan. Some stories say that he died from his wound, and some would say that he went back to America, but little they don't know that he went back to the village where he met with Taka. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.